It's Brian from your grandma's favorite site. So good you gotta bookmark it twice, reviewtheworld.com. But you already know that, man. It's beautiful springtime. And you know, we're like bears. We hibernated through the winter. You didn't see much activity out of Nick and myself, the Review the World team. But now that spring has sprung, we're gonna be kicking it in full speed ahead. Right now, you know, I gotta say something. We have been synonymous with a couple different things, different items, different brands throughout our 12 plus year history. We kind of started this whole thing, Nick, with Rap Snacks.
Yeah.
An obscure hip hop brand of potato chip crisp. But since then, in the last 2, maybe 3 years, I feel like the brand that we have been most connected to has been Airheads. The balloon with the George Foreman nose, I had it upside down. This is it.
It's always vibrantly colored.
And I wanted to point this out. I mean, we are, of course, an Ohio-based website, but a billboard a while back pointed out to me that these are actually made not too far from us over in Kentucky.
Yeah, Erlang is like 30-minute drive.
It's relatively a home staple.
We got to go check out their museum, man. Come on, you know they got one.
Now, to celebrate their own birthday of the company, they have a limited edition flavor, and you know I'm all about that limited edition scene. Birthday cake. How are they gonna pull that off? I don't know. You don't know. Fans at home, you probably don't know, unless you got a stash.
You know, that's been like a lot of companies, they kind of follow after each other too and do similar flavors, and birthday cake seems to be also one of the newest. There's like birthday cake M&M's.
I had those.
I know, and they're actually really good. There's other birthday cake items I can't think of, but it has me wondering, like,
is this a trend?
Is this like a creamy? Is this going to be creamy? Right. Is it going to be typical tart?
Because usually the Airheads flavors mostly fall in line with fruit.
Yeah.
I can't think of there's been a lot of variations on the said fruit theme, and occasionally they'll even throw in add-ins, which we saw but in a past video. The sour fuel.
Yeah.
Go back, hit the archives. However, guys, it's the unpacking scene. Without further ado, whoa!
That's like glowing on camera.
I know, it's super bright. Maybe if you look at it against my shirt.
Yeah, the specks are starting to kind of come out. There you go.
It's almost like sprinkles.
Yeah.
Rainbow sprinkles. There's yellow, orange, green, blue. Very awesome.
In the light, it has the look of like glow-in-the-dark items. Like if you held it up to the sun and put it in the dark, it would glow.
All right. First bite. This is nice. A brisk morning like this, sun's coming out, something sweet on the palate. There's a lot of chewing involved with Airheads, so I apologize. Nick, I think we have a winner. Like, to me, this feels like the best cupcake from childhood.
Oh.
It feels more to me like, you know, if I had to associate it blindly, I would probably say cupcake more than birthday cake, but same ballpark, right? Same general concept. Mm. And I don't care what you do now as an adult for your birthday party, whether you hit Vegas, whether you're down Florida at Disney World, whether you're doing anything, nothing beats those childhood birthday parties where you're in the backyard. You know, you ordered pizza, you're playing basketball or swimming, you rented some videos from the video store that day.
Oh, yeah.
Because, you know, you're going to stay up late and have the pizza party, watch, you know, Hellraiser 2 or whatever it might be. I like this a lot. Airheads, you've never really let me down. I don't think there's been a bad Airheads flavor.
I can't really recall being disappointed.
This one's an awesome one. I need to go find some more of these, one for, you know, the collector shelf, because this ain't going to be around for too long. Happy birthday, Airheads. Guys, Review the World, it's going to be kicking off major. Nick, you got to try this.
Yes.
Hey, everybody. It's Nick along the scenic and sometimes not so scenic Great Miami River. I mean, it's urban beauty, but, you know, not everybody's cup of tea. Going to try my first little bite of the Airheads thing. And I've been smelling it here for a couple minutes, especially because we're having a little bit of camera problems, and we were able to fix that.
Crisis averted.
Yeah, that was a close one. I almost had to eat this off camera. But it smells like something. I cannot put my finger on it, so I'm just going to go ahead and just rip on into it. Oh, God, hard.
Yeah, I think that's because it's a little chilly this morning. It's been in the car as we made our trip downtown.
I see what you're talking about too, Brian, with the cupcake thing.
Sure.
And I think it's because cake, like the icing on cake is usually a little thicker and kind of heavier. But this has kind of a lighter,
absolutely,
like creamier taste. Almost also like those soft cookies you get at Kroger and they have the little icing on it.
There you go.
I'm not big into those cookies because I think they're not cooked enough. But that's kind of what it reminds me of, is the icing that comes on those in the cupcakes. So I definitely see the cupcake reference, but it's really chewy. It's kind of stuck on the side of my teeth now.
I gotta say, but visually too, they could have just made it the white color, but the fact that they put the little sprinkle
it's a nice little touch.
Dashes does make it a little bit more colorful. It makes it unique in the world of Airhead, and so kudos for that as well.
It's really good. It's really sweet and sugary, especially starting to come on
right
now that's starting to really dissolve.
I think that's a good thing that it comes in a six-pack with other flavors, so you don't have a lot of that. You have just enough, probably.
It also kind of reminds me of, now, I don't know how many fans are going to know about this, so this I'm going to specifically be talking to you, Brian. Do you remember when we did the Review the World birthday cake?
Yes.
And we made our own icing?
Absolutely.
It kind of tastes like that.
If you're wanting to get the reference, it's back there in the archives. Nick, did you lose a shoe?
Oh.
Is that your size? But no, if you look it up, it's called the, I believe, RTW Opening Party, or something to that extent, Opening Party, Opening Celebration, something like that. Anyhow, we made a, Nick and I had never baked in our lives. We were young teenagers. This is like almost 12 years ago.
Yeah.
And we made a cake. And it had some interesting...
Before we even knew that Review the World was going to be a website, and it was just going to be more of a YouTube channel.
Right.
Which, did that even really...
No, this actually predated YouTube. It was just going to be a thing. I don't think it had a label at that point.
Just find a way to post it like we did the old UWO videos in high school. But, that being said, it does have a very strong, very sweet flavor. I was a little apprehensive because it is Airheads, but birthday cake. I wasn't sure if they were still going to try to throw in something tart, you know, in the back door or something. But no, it's really good. Airheads, I applaud you. Erlanger, Kentucky, we're coming to find you. All right, guys, thanks for watching the video. Happy birthday,
Brian,
to
wait.
Airheads. And what's going on, man? Somebody coming?
I noticed a shirt earlier.
Oh, yeah.
Nice shirt.
Oh, and why? But New York, Matt Seltzer.
But where the hat come from? Are we doing product placements now?
Are we doing this on camera right now? Okay, since you've asked, man, our last video earlier this month in April, it was, you know, original New York seltzer sodas. Okay, well, the video went up and it went viral, and within 48 hours, the company contacted me. Okay, they had me in the offices. I brought back some swag. Anyhow, they said, cool video, guys. And Nick, it was you, man, that mentioned the carbonation levels maybe were a little off. They said, listen, that's not our drink. Let us put our best foot forward. They sent a couple care packages. They sent some swag. And our next video, which is right around the corner, Tuesday, May 10th, mark it on your calendars. We're reviewing three more original New York seltzer flavors. Last time, Nick, we did five, and they were great. Liked them all. Now we're doing three more.
What?
That's right, baby. Three more flavors. At this point, we'll have reviewed eight total. Original New York seltzer, we're going to see you. Put your best foot forward, because we're going to review you. Even though you sent it, we're going to be honest. We're going to try them. We're going to see how they are.
Yeah, we're not pulling any punches. You better fix that carbonation level.
We'll see you guys Tuesday, May 10th. Look for it.
I don't think I'm icy. I think I'm a IP. Niggas want to fight me? That's unnecessary. I don't quit for shit. That's my legendary.